Welcome back to spreadsheetpoint.com. In this brief video, I will go over a simple cryptocurrency tracker that can be created in Google Sheets using the Google Finance function. So the main data columns here are currency, which is the name of the currency identifier, which is the ticker. The investment is how much you've put into the fund. The holding, which is how much of the currency do you actually own based on your investments and the buying price. The current price, which is where the Google Finance function comes into play, which I'll explain in a moment. The present value of your initial investments and the profit loss. So let's go over this Google Finance function. Now keep in mind, these gray columns are formulas, so you wouldn't edit the data that is in these, same with the last one here. So the Google Finance function, the syntax is simply Google Finance, and then it's quotation, currency, colon, and then your currency. So let's just do BTC, USD, and then quotation to close, and then bracket. And you'll see it brings that up just like that. Okay. I've simplified the formula to allow you to only enter the currency here. And then so this formula grabs the currency identifier and then adds USD to it. If you're using a different currency to buy the funds, you would just change the name here and then simply edit the formula. Instead of USD, it would be CAD, just like that. And then you would bring the formula down. But I'm going to undo that here, just so. So what this is doing here, it's bringing in real-time current pricing of these currencies here, which is quite powerful. That is what's great about Google Finance, is it will bring in the current price of any currency identifier that you enter in here without having to install any technical or complex API scripts or extensions in your Google Sheets. Google Finance is a function that's built right into Google Sheets. So let's say I wanted to add a different currency here. Let's say I wanted to use Litecoin. So you type in the name of the currency, you type in the currency identifier, which is LTC, I believe, and you'll see automatically it pops in that price right there. Investment, let's say we invested 1,000, and then you're going to skip that column. Buying price, so the current price is 106. Let's say we bought it at 100. You'll see we have 10 units essentially, and then our present value of our $1,000 investment based on the price that we bought it at versus what it is now is $1,067. And that gives us a profit, of course, of $6,730. And as you add in different currencies here, it will update here on the chart. Let's add in one more, XRP. P, and then the ticker is the same thing, I believe. Let's say we bought 5,000 of that. We'll put a loss this time. So the current price is 234. Say we bought that at $3. So you'll see our initial investment is 5,000. We bought it at three. It's now 234. So that's our present value of 3,900. So that's a loss of $1,100, which is reflected in the chart down here. Keep in mind, these quotes are not sourced from all markets and may be delayed up to 20 minutes. So this is a nice disclaimer down here that Google Sheets does add in as well. But if you were just looking for a simple cryptocurrency tracker to track your investments over time and not using it for day trading or anything like that, this would be a perfect tool for your use. I hope you found this video helpful. For more information, please visit spreadsheetpoint.com and don't forget to like and subscribe.